prepared for the Rangers' speed.
Speed. In Montreal, it's symbolic with decades of success. But in Game 1, the Canadiens were dazzled by a blue streak. Tapped ahead, up the wing is Kreider! Score! And Zuccarello able to wheel around behind. A little feed for Richards! He scores! New York speed was fortified by New York skill, led by their supremely confident goaltender. But Carey Price and the Canadiens were caught flat-footed, and now they've lost their star between the pipes. Facing adversity, Montreal must find their game and match these Rangers stride for stride. Game 2, next. Sound and more lights inside Bell Center. The 408th straight shutout. 21,273. The last time they had an empty seat. January 8th of 04. In semi-darkness, you can see the diagonal letters of the New York Rangers. There will be a tremendous ovation for the home team. There always is. But particularly tonight, because they are led by a goaltender who has not played in these playoffs before. And he is their hope to not have to win four of the five games that would follow. He's 24, he's Dustin Tokarski, and here he comes. With the Canadiens, Max Pacioretty.
Thanks very much, Doc. You lost game one. You lost your starting goalie. What's the mental attitude around your team?
We got to rally around it. We got a great kicker back there right now. We got confidence in him. We got to help him out.
Everybody knows the start is so important in this building. How do you have to have a good start?
Yeah, I don't think this team has played against a loud crowd yet, so hopefully we can get the crowd in the game and use it to our advantage.
Thanks a lot, Max. Have some fun tonight.
The towels are being waved. It is very noisy, but it will soon grow quiet. We will hear both anthems. The U.S. sung by a 19-year-old recording star, the second by a much-loved legendary vocalist and actress. Here's PA announcer Michel Lacroix.
Mesdames, messieurs, veuillez maintenant vous lever, retirer chapeaux et casquettes pour l'interprétation de l'hymne national des États-Unis. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Remove your hats and caps for the singing of the American National Anthem by Miss Sarah Diamond.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rang like the bomb bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there.
Now for the Canadian National Anthem, Madame Ginette Renault.
Understand. Singing along, the coach of the 93 Cup champs, Jacques Demers, you may have seen him, and Prime Minister Stephen Harper. Henrik Lundqvist, 82nd straight playoff start, faced 22 shots, saved 20, got his 39th playoff victory Saturday afternoon. Humboldt, Saskatchewan has a population of 6,526. That would fill up less than a third of this arena. That's where Dustin Tokarski is from. He gets his first Stanley Cup start with the Canadiens. He had two regular season starts, a 2-0 shutout, and a shootout. Both of them victories. Alex Galchenyuk, out for the first 12 games of the playoffs, is back for Montreal tonight. Michael Bournival will be out. That's the only other change besides in goal. The first shot flies by, and Nash is able to tip it back. Do you sense, Eddie, that the Rangers are sensing a surge at the start, so they're going to be careful?
Well, you would assume that the Canes are going to play much better than they did early in that game.
Sliding into the net was Nash and Gallagher and Lundqvist, so to speak, and a crowd gathers.
And another big adjustment. No Amelin and no Markov against the top line of the New York Rangers with the speed of Kreider. It's Subban and Georges.
Well, a quick little transition play through the middle of the ice. David Desharnais gets his puck to the net, and there you see Rick Nash trying to keep up with Brendan Gallagher, and the same net that Chris Kreider and Carey Price went into. Price out for this series. Henrik Lundqvist having to be on his toes early in this game. Let's not forget back in game one, Henrik Lundqvist made a couple of huge stops in period two when the game was 2-0 for his team. He stopped Subban, he stopped Pacioretty. The Canadiens did have some good looks, but not enough for their liking.
A giveaway there by Staal, played along now by Eller, and then along for the punch by Giambrone. Two stops by Lundqvist on Bork. My goodness. Along to the outside, it's Hamelin on back to Markov. Fires a shot back. It would not work. It went off of Hagelin. Puck back up the boards. Richards trying to get there. Kept alive by Yemelin. Turned back along by Eller. And blocked down by Strawman. And reached by Staal, but not out. Yemelin is shot. Popped up high. And behind. Good challenge here from Montreal early. It is Bork feeding Gianta. Able to play it along. Strawman in the way. Gives on to Hagelin. And Hagelin steps to the safety of center. And flies it back in. Artie Saint-Louis wanted to play there, but Yemelin got there first, and quickly they move it back out. Eller tried to get to center, run off there by Pouliot, and the puck kicked right back in where Lundqvist had to plane it on to Girardi. Bam on the first try, but got it along to McDonough, and then Galchenyuk stepped into him. Rifled all the way back down, a race on, and it is icing. There will be penalties early. least one. Wes McCauley, one of the referees, has signaled that.
Well, in Dominic Moore's defense, he doesn't know that this is going to be icing until the last second. That's why he pulls up. He doesn't take a full shot on Tokarski. And then everybody comes together because he did shoot the puck after the whistle. But Dominic Moore is doing what he's supposed to do, and he pulled up at the last second.
And you talk about a good start for Montreal, Doc and Eddie. Henrik Lundqvist with a real good start for the New York Rangers. Opportunity off the cycle, two different opportunities out front. And Henrik Lundqvist is huge against Rene Bork.
Well, this was a turnover after a faceoff win by the Rangers. Mark Stahl turned it over. Tried to reverse the puck, went right into the forecheck and pressured Gianta with a great pass and two big-time stops there for Henrik Lundqvist.
It'll be four aside, unsportsmanlike on Moore, and roughing on Nathan Beaulieu. Subban settles it down. Challenged by Stepan, reverses and floats by the pitcher, and he was Lundqvist. Now Girardi wanted to play to Stepan, but it is Subban.
Another good stop from Lundqvist early.
George is upended a bit. This one floated back out and away from Pacioretty. McDonough can play it off. Stepan guides it back, and it's Girardi. 35 seconds into the coincidental. Brought ahead by Zuccarello. Pivots with it there. Rifled one across for John Moore. Moore brought it back, put on the brakes. And it's slugged across now to Strahlman. Strahlman yet again. Moore around behind. Met by Yemelin. The crunch there off of Markov and taken on. A 3-on-2. Plekanec brings it on. Tried to feather it through for Gianta. Plekanec turning, and it's rescued by Pouliot on the turning stick of John Moore.
Good job there by Anton Strahlman to come over and help out Benoit Pouliot, who was a forward filling in for John Moore, who was below the goal line on that offensive push.
Ryder is being booed as he touches the puck. Somewhere Zdeno Chara understands. Eller trying to work his way in. It's tapped on along for the follow-up by Georges. Given on to Eller. Then Gallagher. Fought off by Lundqvist. On it comes to Georges. Slips it back across and a stiff pass that Subban has to flag down.
Boy, a real sharpness and quickness to the game for the Canadians to start here. Not even 3.5 minutes in. They know how important this game is.
Four chances in the game, all from Montreal. And we get a stoppage of play on an offside.
Well, quality chances so far against Henrik Lundqvist. Turnover by Klein. Quick opportunity. And Doc, you pointed out beautifully. Lundqvist fighting off that chance from Gallagher.
PK Subban moves the puck up. Ryan McDonough was a little over aggressive, and Pacioretty gets a quality chance. Lundqvist fights that off again.
Yeah, right off the left pad.
That was Graham Reinman, the athletic trainer of the Canadiens, talking to PK Subban on the bench.
Markov from Yemelin gives it back to him with Plekanec and Thomas Vanek up front. Both teams get a man back, and it's Boyle. Ryan Boyle able to shunt one ahead that bounced on, and we get a stoppage of play as it had careened out of play near the bench. For extensive series coverage from the Stanley Cup playoffs, go to NHL.com from your computer or phone. Get video highlights and in-depth analysis of every game directly from the expert.
Well, the one thing that is obvious in this game is that the Canadians realize that it can't be a game of one-on-one hockey. You got to have strength and number support, especially as you're entering the offensive zone or in those cycles. We saw the great chance for Bork early. Two Canadian players real close to the puck. So far, exactly the type of start that the Canadians would want. 5-0 in favor of them on shots on goal.
Eric Brassard is not playing. Left early in game one. Daniel Carcillo takes his spot and is out there now. Around it comes. Beaulieu fed it behind, but Girardi took over there. Sent it off the short glass and back. It is Briere rubbed out by Boyle, who tried to center, and that paddled away by Tokarski. Dealt along now for Price. Not a shot by the Rangers on the young goaltender yet. Brought on now
by Dale Weiss. Weiss piddled it off, and it went on through for the return, but now it's poked back out again by Carcillo, though re-grabbed by Georges. Ricocheted loose, and San Luis started in. An onside play, and a little extra hit from Weiss. Now it's San Luis around in front. Oh, the save made by Tokarski. The first Rangers shot, not simple. Belt to the corner, Strawman there, roughed up by Prust, and now it is San Luis again. Moving out with Richards, plays it on a cross, lugged back by Stahl, dropped off for Richards. Richards a drive, and that went over his glove and caught the glass. Played on by Strawman, yanked around behind, and it ricocheted off Richards, taken along by Eller. Eller one-hands it, but into Nash, who wheels right back. Nash trying to get loose and cannot. Some good defensive work by Josh Georges. Now Eller run into there by Haglund. Hoisted on out again by Georges. The bouncer was away from Bourque. Pivoting back his stall, circle to Strawman, and then back out off of Stepan and deep. Yemelin run into there. Poked along behind in traffic. Trying to work three is Nash. Came on across now for Yemelin. Outletted ahead for Bourque. And Bourque lobs it back in. Desharnais will get there. John Moore cancels him out so it can be played by Stepan.
Look what Desharnais pulled up on that play there. He had a chance to get that puck.
He guides it on back now for Markov. Fires! Oh, and that one pinball just wide. Played on back again for Yemelin. Around behind Desharnais. Looks to the slot. Gedlin across, and that one kicked aside again as Moore was near the front of the net. Rattled on around, Gallagher hustling after it. One times it right back around behind, through Pacioretty, though, and it can be guided back by Desharnais to Markov. Then Pacioretty, but off his stick. Regathers, big one, shot, and that one wouldn't go. Onto the back, it comes now to Markov again. Angles one for Gallagher, and that one ricocheted off Desharnais. And wide, Pacioretty tries to slip one in front. Zuccarello has trouble, battled along, caught the net.
Shift. And this line out here against the third defensive pairing for the Rangers. Kevin Klein and Johnny Moore out on the ice. The turnover by Matt Zuccarello. The poke check by Lundqvist off of Pacioretty into the back of the net.
Michel Therrien deserves a huge assist today. I heard what you said, but it's been a puck pursuit of the Canadians and the speed factor of the Canadians that was not there and apparent in game one. It's a pretty apparent here in game two to start.
There are great expectations for 67 in red. He has brought them to their feet here. First goal of the series for him, his fourth of the playoffs. This is game 13. Forced on along by Dominic Moore, but Plekanec got there, reversed it up, and it's McDonough shot. Score! A deflection in front, and the game is tied.
Well, we talked about Ryan McDonough in the open. A flawless game one. This puck finds him back at the blue line. Quick transition through the middle of the ice. Dominic Moore, smart little play. Gets it in behind P.K. Subban. And then the physical contact. And then the shot. And it goes off of Josh Georges' backside. Past Tokarski.
Chip, chase, and check by Dominic Moore. And it's just a support on the forecheck. There's a chip. There's a chase. And watch the support for Dominic Moore from Benoit Pouliot. He's there. That gets it back to McDonough. And eventually he just smashes it past Tokarski. The two chances for Tokarski, Doc, and Eddie hadn't been easy. He stopped the first one from St. Louis, didn't stop that one through a maze of players.
And bouncing off of Josh Georges' backside. There's Georges going to the front of the net. The puck is on edge, and there, right off the right hip. What an answer back there from the Rangers. Something they needed desperately.
You're going to have potential action here with Weiss and Carcillo, and Wes McCaw is going to come over and say about enough.
And the fun word in all of that, if you're those two, is about.
because it's not enough yet, which gives you some hope, right? Well, anyway, banged on out off of Strawman, ricocheted back and is poked into Boyle. Boyle able to step back in, and a shot turned aside by Tokarski and then carried back up by Weiss. Hunted down by Dorsett. Nice move to get it across. Beaulieu, and that deflected wide. On around for a crunch by Prust. The crunchers are out there for these teams right now. Carcillo tangles at the boards. Played along for Briere. Then to Prust behind, but it skipped off him. Played on by Klein. Gathered in by Dorsett. Rolled back in, and he goes galloping after it. Dorsett to the corner. Oh, was he ever crunched there by Weaver. And a chance is thrown back along now for Weiss.
Nice chance there for Carl Hagelin off the crazy turnover and the opportunity, and a good stop there from Tokarski.
That was a great play by Dorsett, much like Dominic Moore. Chip, chase, and check. That created that chance for the Rangers.
It is Bork delaying and throwing one into the glove of Lundqvist. You're watching the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by GEICO on NBCSN. Pacioretty, McDonough, 1-1.
Well, great things happen when the puck goes towards the net. And unfortunately here for the Rangers, it's directed towards the net, off of Lundqvist, off of Pacioretty to the back of the net. And here, Ryan McDonough. Unfortunately for the Canadians, it goes off of Josh Georges. But anytime that puck is directed around the net, something could happen. If you don't get the puck near the net, nothing's going to happen. Two goals on a couple of crazy bounces.
It is Markov. And that one ricocheted off of Richards to the corner. Hagelin flies it. Glove down and played by Gallagher. Gallagher played one where he thought Yemelin would be.
Right idea, though. Right idea there.
And Stahl. But it bounced free, and then he knifed it away. Gallagher able to retreat and play, and then along to Pacioretty. Shoved a bit by Strawman, wedging in Desharnais. It's played along and ricocheted off of Yemelin. The turn by Richards. Stahl can't get out with it. Good persistence by the Canadians here. Pacioretty trying to push it through Stahl. Then a jab from behind by Yemelin, and the whistle finally blown. Experienced referees here in Wes McCauley and Dan O'Halloran. They worked the final game last year in the playoffs, Game 6 in Boston, with the Bruins and Blackhawks.
Coming out of that last TV timeout, Ulf Samuelsson didn't get fooled. He had Strawman and Stahl on the ice ready for the top line of the Canadiens, Desharnais, Pacioretty, and Gallagher. There was no third tandem on the ice, so a little bit of coaching savvy from Ulf Samuelsson.
Off this tie-up, Stepan shoves it ahead. Kreider tried to take it, but before the Blues could really reach full tilt, it was off his stick, thrown back in again. So Lundqvist
must have went to school on that mismatch that happened when the Canadians scored their goal.
That's exactly
a couple of minutes before that.
Bork connects with Eller across to Gionta. Gionta drifting now through one that was off McDonough. A long jam of players behind, helped along by Stepan, but gotten again by Bork. Bork tried to play it through Stepan, and then Eller. Moving to this is Bork with Eller in front, guides it to the back. Subban with a shot, waffle boarded right back out again by Lundqvist and played to center for Kreider to lob in.
Subban again with Georges against Kreider. They're not going to let his speed get involved tonight if they can help it.
Weaving his way back along now and rifling it in is Josh Georges, but it's out of play. Dunkin' Donuts takes you inside the glass. Here's Pierre.
A new tactic in the National Hockey League because of the way obstruction is called. Chip, chase, and check. Here's Derek Dorsett against Nathan Boyle. You see he can't hold him up. So the one race by Dorsett, that creates an unbelievable opportunity for Hagelin. Here's the other one. Dominic Moore, there, Benoit Pouliot supporting Ryan McDonough off Josh Georges. Short side shoot-ins. Scotty Bowman and the Detroit Red Wings, especially with those live boards in Detroit, Eddie and Doc, they really worked on those in the mid-1990s and in the early 2000s, and it became in vogue for a lot of teams.
That's when you can hook and hold.
Correct.
Our scoring stats would have been different both then and as everything evolved from the lockout in the mid part of this last decade. A shot flew wide.
Screen there from Vanek going hard to the net. Very quiet game one for Thomas Vanek.
He is brought here to do more, is he not?
Well, he had a big impact in that Boston series, and at times he went very quiet, but all of a sudden, a couple power play goals and come off the stick of Thomas Vanek.
Marcello now moves back ahead with Dominic Moore. A head fake there, and it's taken right away. And a good move by Georges. Off of Pacioretty, who controls, tried to work it on back, and the play was thrown offside. Sunday, the lavish life of Monaco spills onto the track of F1's most celebrated Grand Prix. It's the biggest party of the year. The Formula One Grand Prix of Monaco live Sunday morning, 7:30 on NBC.
Clearly, Michel Therrien wants his hammers on the ice whenever the Rangers hammers are on. Preston Dorset, Carcillo, and Weiss, or Reese, I should say, excuse me.
Easy to get those matchups when whistles happen and the visitors got to put their lineup in first. That's where you get those mismatches, and that's what we saw in the first Canadian goal with Pacioretty goal. Dorset brushed it along. Doubling back was Boyle, taking it Girardi, and ahead for Carcillo. Mystic winger able to trickle one back in. Went through Tokarski, along for Prost. And then a slide, and then more kicking along by Dorset. There is no scoreboard urging here. Spontaneous cheering, broken up a bit with an O as the Rangers unable to hold, and then it's fired into a lot of traffic by John Moore. Kicked along by Dorset, a lot of shoving on Briere. And then walked on by Gallagher, could not get by Richards.
Still a wrestling match around the bench area.
Desharnais brings it on and fires straight. Lundqvist rebound, Pacioretty backhanded it wide. What seemed like nothing became something not once but twice. Gallagher again, then back on to Desharnais with Pacioretty near the net. Desharnais twists and plays it behind. McDonough to defend on Pacioretty, able to force it through but pinching his Markov. Away from San Luis, Markov bashed it on. Gallagher sent it behind. Pacioretty with it there. Led to the back, Yemelin. Given across now to Markov. Then on a cross, Pacioretty shot is caught off by Lundqvist. Then to the back, Markov again. Wrist one, well wide. Bounced over to Girardi, canceled out though. And so it is handed on across for a play back to center by San Luis. Flung wide, Yemelin there. Pestered by Hagelin, reversed it on to Markov.
Boy, what a release by Pacioretty off that pass from Markov.
I'm ready to play tonight. You could see it when I was interviewing him, too. There was a certain intensity that you could see in him that was not there in game one.
Will this be icing? It will. 8:01 to go first period. Shots 11-4 Montreal, game tied at one. Unassisted goals by Pacioretty and McDonough.
Or at least 4 8-plus chances for the Montreal Canadiens here in period one, and there's a great chance there from David Desharnais coming in, creating the chance, and then here's the Pacioretty chance. Quick release and the stop by Henrik Lundqvist.
It's almost like the goal that he scored in the Boston series when Desharnais set it up on a tee for him. He blew it by Tuukka Rask.
At game seven, second goal of the game.
Gianta chopped it back in, Lundqvist out to handle. John Moore takes over there. Ryder turned it over. Gianta with a shot. Shrugged down and then paddled into some traffic by Lundqvist, but it comes along now for Kreider. Kreider staggers down, then is checked by Gianta, captain of the Canadiens. Eller worked to run through, and now Gianta can bring it ahead. Trying to get through three Rangers, no luck. Cleared out of play and out to center by Nash. Rushing right back with it is Subban. Turns, dips the shoulder, and tries to march further. Jostled there by Pouliot. Puck along the boards near Gianta. Swings one in front that's calmly blocked in the crouch by Lundqvist. Then it skipped on through. Rene Bork tries to work further and cannot. Strawman pulled away and got it back up the board for the play by Dominic Moore. And Moore able to tip it back in. The ex-Canadian goes right after it again, but it's hoisted away from him by Bouillot. Moore jostling on the boards. Aggressive game here. Under 7 minutes to go. First period, game two, tied at one. Dominic Moore turning with that and swinging it on back to Girardi. Galchenyuk out there with Plekanec as well as Vanek. That's the front line for the Montreal Canadiens. McDonough swings it back in. Chopped on by Weaver, taken by Vanek. swings it ahead. Galchenyuk able to take over there and move back in with it. Surrounded by Rangers. Pouliot a shot over the shoulder of Lundqvist in against the glass.
What a rush there by Galchenyuk.
Pretty special player, third overall in the 2012 draft. He's got magnificent hand skills and peripheral vision. This is what Eddie's talking about, a little example of his handiwork. He'll gain the line, Galchenyuk, and distribute to Nathan Beaulieu, who'll let a scorcher go.
Well, Chris Kreider here. This is something that the Ranger wingers are going to see a lot of, is that the Canadiens defenseman really being aggressive to keep plays alive, and that turnover by Kreider gives Gionta the opportunity.
Stall a drive, shred right down by Tokarski, and a penalty is coming up. Cleared out of play into the Montreal bench. The call is a trip, and it will be a Ranger coming to the box. Hagelin to the box. Habs to the power play, tied at one. Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre's with Montreal head coach Michel Therrien.
You lost Carey Price. You went to Dustin Tokarski. Take us through your mindset when you made that decision.
Well, you know what? The kid, first of all, played well for us when he came in a few games. But the most important thing is a winner. You look at his background. He won everywhere, so we got confidence out of kid.
You must be happy with your start. Subban against Kreider. Is that what you're looking for, to take the speed out?
Yeah, you know what? I like the way that we're pushing the game. We're setting the tone with first on puck. That's the way we're supposed to play.
Excellent, coach.
All right.
And Giretti punches it on back. Subban walks it across. Make the drive. Gave it on over to Desharnais. Vardy watching him. Power play on because of the trip to Hagelin. Thrown on across by Markov. Slowed down there. Taken by Desharnais. Back to the back. Subban a drive. And it went off a leg in front. Backhand toss to the front of the net. Miscramble. But it's poked away by McDonough. Up the boards now for Boyle. Clipped it on across. And Zuccarello one-on-one with Subban. Rolled it back in to take up some more time and then moves right in after it. And we get a halt to play, and a slashing penalty has been called here, and Thomas Vanek will go to the box.
He's mad because he got knocked down in the slot, and Wes McCauley caught him. He wanted a call against the Rangers earlier. Didn't happen. Then he got angry and retaliated. You can't do that. Eddie knows this more than anything else. There's a slash on Ryan McDonough right into the hand area. But it happened earlier in the high slot. He got knocked down after he blocked his own man's shot, PK Subban's shot, and he got ticked off by it.
Four on four now. Neither team scored at four on four in game number one. As this is poked free off the draw, and Yemelin sends it along to Markov. Eller and Gallagher are the other Canadians. Stepan and Nash, Stroman, as well as Staal for the New York Rangers, and Lundqvist then to Staal. Has to get some help, and Nash is there to provide. Marches it back out off of Staal's stick, but carried on by Stepan. Stepan a shot that's steered wide by Markov off the back of the cage, peeled off by Eller. Changes in line. What do you think so far, Ed?
Well, I think a terrific start for sure for if you're the Montreal Canadiens, but you love how the Rangers were able to answer right back when the Canadiens had scored and come right back because they had nothing going on.
The turn and the take by Gionta, flipped it on across Plekanec. Plekanec a blast, and that deflected up out of play off of Girardi. 4 3/4 minutes to go, first period of play. The game in Montreal is tied at one.
Well, to go back to that penalty by Thomas Vanek, you see the puck Ryan McDonough's going for. He's going to move the puck up. But watch where the stick is of Thomas Vanek. Instead of getting it up in the air, get it on the ice. First of all, you're not going to take a penalty. And then he slaps down there on the hand. So if he gets the stick on the ice, maybe he prevents McDonough from moving the puck up the ice. That's his main job, not to sit there and hack over his hands. You got to move your feet, get your stick on the ice, and maybe you intercept that play.
Here is McDonough, who has points in 4 of the last 5 Rangers goals in this series. Staal rattled it back in. It is Subban, pestered, but he's able to shake free. It'll be a 34-second power play for the Rangers a dozen seconds from now. Staal to turn with it there. Bunted behind now for San Luis and up the boards for Richards. Rifle on the cross right to Desharnais. Fed it on to Markov. Right. Oh, and what a save by Lundqvist on Pacioretty.
Richards started the whole play. What another outstanding stop there by Henrik Lundqvist.
Eddie, they have to start elevating the puck. Too much is too low on Henrik Lundqvist. He'll devour those.
The giveaways are 8-2 Rangers. The eighth one almost broke the tie shorthanded.
Well, Brad Richards coming back against the grain in his own zone. St. Louis, Richards has got it, no problem. And he comes back looking for St. Louis. Desharnais, perfect pass to Markov. And what a chance again for Max Pacioretty.
Speaking of chances, 10-3 Montreal. Eight of the last nine shots have been off Canadian sticks. We are tied at one. 5 seconds left on the power play as it's finessed on through for Kreider. Dropped it on back. Stall drive! And that one ticked aside. Played back up the boards off of George's. On to center. Full strength action. And it is Strahlman. Took one along that bounced off press, taken ahead by Nash, handed on to Stepan. Stepan the shot, it's sealed up by Tokarski. The credentials that Michel Therrien talked about and you talked about before the game. Memorial Cup MVP and championship, gold medalist for Canada in the World Junior, stopping 39-40 against Sweden for the title. A Calder Cup championship with a dozen wins for the Norfolk Admirals 2 years ago. A credentialed goaltender who gets his baptism in fire here in Montreal.
The 09 World Junior goal was something special. That performance against Jakob Markstrom and the Swedes was just off the charts in Ottawa.
Eller to take this draw opposite Moore with 3:21 to go. Pulled free by Zuccarello and a shot ricocheted across off a Montreal stick. Turnarounder by Moore. Rebound Zuccarello blocked off by Eller. After the save by Tokarski. To the back now Girardi. Laid back along for Zuccarello. Couldn't get it to the front again. A strong play made there by Markov and a shot shanked wide off of Pouliot and off the glass. Poked on three by Eller. Gotten by Zuccarello. Able to peel away with it now. Zuccarello rifled it across. Oh, and a shot stopped by Tokarski. As pinching back in was McDonough. And the puck is iced.
Well, this similar set here for the Rangers. This last shift is what we saw a lot of. Saw a lot of in game one. Defenseman getting involved. The Rangers winning some foot races. Right part of your screen. Here comes Ryan McDonough. And there you see Tokarski move left to right. Compact. Make the save.
And the Canadiens bench was yelling at the Canadiens forwards. Coming back door. Coming back door. They couldn't hear.
Oh, that's Piazza's man.
Yep.
Nice play there from Zuccarello.
Bork plays it back in. Gianta after it. And we get a halt to play here and another icing.
Well, Doc, you were talking about Dustin Tokarski a couple of years ago winning that championship in Norfolk. I was going through some old notes. I had a chance to visit with John Cooper talking about Dustin Tokarski right when he got the Tampa Bay job. And you think about it, Tokarski started the series. He beat Manchester. He lost in the second round games 3 and 4 to Connecticut. Cooper pulled him. Did not play him. He played Yaroslav Yanis. He played him games 5 and 6 in round 2. Everybody thought he was going to stay with Yanis. What did he do? He went back to Tokarski. He swept St. John's in the semifinals and then swept the Marlies to win the championship. So you talk about toughness, mental toughness. Certainly Dustin Tokarski personifies that.
8 straight.
After getting yanked.
No pressure there. Gallagher rolls it along. Subban off the short glass and out to center. Played on by Girardi.
And John Cooper now the head coach of the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Brought back on by Gallagher. Holds. Gallagher fed one across. Subban drive! Oh, getting a piece of it was Lundqvist. Gallagher again and that wide. How does that not hurt? Subban again fires one and that one was off the mark. Girardi played one off George's, tapped ahead, and skied back out again by Hagelin. Breaking for it is Richards, but getting there is Subban. The hardest shooter left in the playoffs now that Chara is out. Banked around in deep, and it's Stahl. And then rattled on around for Boyle to connect to Dorsett, and back ahead now for the flop back in by Carcillo. Tokarski there, it's poked on through him. Getting it is Boyle. Shoved a little bit along the boards by Vanek. Oh, and Carcillo rocked in that time on Plekanec. McCullough up from Weaver.
and offside is called.
Derek Dorsett got injured on that last situation. He's on the bench right now, and right in front of Jim Ramsey, the medical trainer.
Yeah, Dorsett in a lot of pain, as Pierre mentioned. Right before that, that great chance from PK Subban walking in and creating an offensive chance.
I like the fact that he elevated the puck. That's one of the few times the Canes elevated against Henrik Lundqvist.
And plays so deep in his net. I mean, he's a reactionary type of goaltender. He makes himself look big. When you look at the net, there's a not a lot to shoot at. This guy is set in game one. This Lundqvist has carried this Ranger franchise for a long, long time.
Is it an icing? Sure enough, it is. We were talking about Tokarski coming from a small town in Saskatchewan. Henrik Lundqvist is from Åre, Sweden. Population, 1,417. However, in tourist season, it swells to, 450,000? Now, where do they put them all?
Maybe it's Hotel Lundqvist.
Maybe. Well, here's Stahl, drubbing one on around that went away from Gionta to center. Settled down by Kreider, and on Stepan, over to Kreider, fed it to Nash! Rick Nash with the second in two games for the Rangers to take the lead.
Well, a simple play. Face-off win, and then the puck ends up going by the Canadian forward along the boards. That's Brian Gionta. Now it's a 3-on-2. Kreider to Stepan. Stepan drives the lane, opens up the lane for Kreider, right to Rick Nash. No chance for Tokarski.
Eddie, you think the speed factor is a little bit intimidating for P.K. Subban? He backs off P.K. Subban, talking about Chris Kreider, and makes that beautiful cross-ice seam pass to Rick Nash, who blows it through to Carson.
That's what Kreider could do. I mean, early in the game here, you talked about how it was offsetting the speed factor of Chris Kreider of having Subban on the ice with Georges, and really for the first time, a clear-cut play through the middle of the ice. But Stepan makes the whole play. Move the puck, move yourself, open up the lane. No chance. As Rick Nash with that quick release puts it into the back of the net.
Today at practice, the Rangers were talking about how they thought that goal by Nash in game number one was really going to take a lot of pressure off him in terms of offense. And you're seeing he wants the puck.
It is Stepan in, tried to swing to Kreider on the wing. That blocked and ahead Gallagher. Connects with Desharnais, met by a couple of Rangers, and decided to throw it on through. Chased down by Yemelin, away from Kreider. Yemelin further, and then Markov.
If you think about the score, Rangers lead 2-1. I mean, it could easily be 3-2 Canadians with the quality of chances. Of the Canadians with 6 A-plus chances in this first period, and Henrik Lundqvist has allowed his team to have the lead very late here in the first period.
Scoring chances are 12-6 Montreal. Out of the 12, 8 extremely good.
Oh yeah, 6 A-pluses for sure. And a couple have missed the net, and those don't count.
Gallagher and Dominic Moore, and then Markov. 22 to go. Off the leg of Desharnais, lifted back in, getting back onside Pouliot, thrown back out off Desharnais, and back down again, no icing, and we're down to the last 12. Stahl smoked out by Vanek, it's played on to Pouliot, skies one that flops on back near Georges, who handballed it along in some traffic, and that'll finally bring the siren and the end to period one of Dustin Tokarski's playoff career. Coming up on the Lexus Intermission Report, Liam, Mike, and Keith are set to bring you the report. Keith will break down the Canadians' early push. And since we've been talking about Tokarski so much, Mike Milbury will tend to the goaltender. siren has gone. 20 minutes have passed. New York Rangers with a late goal by Rick Nash have the lead in the contest 2-1. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by Lexus and their pursuit of perfection. And by Coors Light. Cheers, Richard H. You're the super cold fan of the week. Looks like Richard H. has a friend there, doesn't it? Rangers 2, Montreal 1 as we start the second period. Let's look at the Coors Light cold hard facts, Richard. The first 14 games, Rick Nash led the league in shots on goal with 52, did not score, but now he has scored on two of his last three shots, both in this series, and he's a goal-a-game guy now.
That's what happens with goal scorers. You get one, you get two, and you regain that confidence. Still would like to see Rick Nash stop in front of the net every once in a while, hang around the net. Never know when the puck will find you, and it certainly finds a guy like Rick Nash.
Found him there a couple of times, but now it is sent on out for Gallagher, and Gallagher brings it on, delays and shoots one, and an artful save made there by Lundqvist. To the back it comes now for the float back on by Georges. Around it curled for Pacioretty. Read by McDonough, off Pacioretty, and carried back out. Step on, crunch pretty well by Desharnais, and the bouncer goes wide. Shift change for both teams 36 seconds into the second period. George is ahead, and that ladled back in by Desharnais, but they say he did not touch it, and for that reason, there is an icing here.
Oh, a great start for King Henrik. Henrik Lundqvist in that first period. Some quality chances. Two A-plus chances for Rennie Bork. Here, Brendan Gallagher with a chance. David Desharnais with a chance. Thomas Vanek, great effort. Max Pacioretty in front of the net, and a Pacioretty, A-plus-plus chance. Only reason it's a 2-1 lead, because of Henrik Lundqvist.
Bacon's inside your scoring head. What would you tell your players?
Well, I think you got to, I mean, you got to keep drifting the puck upstairs. I think you got to look for that area because he plays so deep in his net. It's either got to be high and hard, crossbar and in, or it's got to be right along the ice.
Icing is called yet again.
I mean, some of the saves are just reactionary, positional saves, and the Canadiens have done a lot of good things. They did a lot of good things in that first period.
One thing they're not going to do, they're not going to be able to get this line away from either Strawman and Staal or McDonough and Girardi. They won't have a repeat for that mismatch that lets them change the ball.
This line is Gallagher and Pacioretty and Desharnais, and they bring it ahead in the person of Gallagher. Gallagher pulls. Backhander was shut off by Girardi's stick and played back out and galloping on, but being screened out by Wes McCauley was Marty St. Louis.
I put my arm up on that one. Interference on McCauley there.
He was an old defenseman drafted by the Detroit Red Wings. That's what he used to do all the time.
Here's Gianta with a shot that flew off of Girardi and got the glass. And then Gianta sent flying by Girardi. And a penalty is coming up. It is Bork turning with his right up and on. A save made by Lundqvist on Eller.
Well, Eddie just showed a primo pack of Henrik Lundqvist's work tonight so far. Just add this one to the reel. Rene Bork out front, pucks along the ice, and what a save by Henrik Lundqvist.
Two penalties on the play, Girardi for cross-checking and a tripping on Eller.
Second time we've seen that tonight in terms of matching minors.
In the days before replay boards, they would simply sit in the box and shake their head. You could predict it. Now they can look at the play that led them there. We should all have that in life, but we don't. Four aside. And it is Staal. Then Nash. And then Stepan. And then back in. And around near Subban. Rush behind in Georges. Guided on ahead for Plekanec. Wanted to play further, but Nash in the way. It came on back for the connect between Staal and Stepan. And then Strawman. Back up to Staal again. delays and then plays it back in. More changes on the part of the Rangers right now as Stepan goes to work and has it. Stopped away by Subban, gotten back by Stepan. The on Zuccarello is able to come up with it, though. Moves to the front, and a ricocheting pass went wide, and a penalty coming up.
That'd be on Subban.
It is stall yet again. Squib free, and it can now be touched by the Canadians. And so the Rangers will go on an unusual-looking power play, 4-3.
What a great shift for Derek Stepan of the New York Rangers. Grinding on the boards, keeping the play alive, frustrating the Montreal Canadiens. They wanted to get the puck, they just couldn't. Watch Stepan, he never quits. Quick active stick on Galchenyuk, and then PK Subban with a right blow right to the chest.
Gonna go back, there's Dan Girardi to clear up those penalties earlier. Cross check right there, penalty. Now watch Girardi, he's gonna circle back to the front of the net, and you wonder how the Canadiens get a great chance. Lars Eller trips, there's the chance. Well, there were the penalties, and then not a good penalty, as Beer showed with PK Subban there with the punch.
Power play is sponsored by Ford. McDonough has it. Held there by Richards. Make the drive. Gave it off. San Luis with it there. On back to McDonough. McDonough shoved it across to Stepan. Then McDonough. Well, it looked like he wanted the one-timer. And a drive by Richards was wide. McDonough again back across to Richards. Just delaying and then changing positions with McDonough for Stepan. Richards across. McDonough saw it go through him but played it on the bounce and turns away from Georges. McDonough, side of the net, San Luis. Through one that banked on back to McDonough. Set it up now for Richards, then San Luis, and off him and wide. It is Stepan and then McDonough again. Both teams get a man back in 20. Stepan across. McDonough's shot is sealed up by Tokarski.
And a little bit of a leg whip there, too, by Mike Weaver in front of the net on Marty St. Louis. A little bit of a different look. Finally, the Rangers put somebody in front of the net. St. Louis goes to the front of the net. Some movement by Richards and McDonough. There's St. Louis. Watch Mike Weaver, 43 in red. Watch his shot. Watch what he does with his right leg at the end. Right there. Kicks out the legs out from behind Marty St. Louis. But Tokarski does a good job of absorbing that shot.
That's the battler, Tokarski, that Michel Therrien was talking about. He doesn't quit on any shots. He's been that way since he played for the Spokane Chiefs in the Western Hockey League.
On this tie-up, Richards and Plekanec, it came across now for Yamelin to walk back out. In a two-on-one, hustling back now, Zuccarello. Yamelin has shot it, went wide, and rolled down the back of the net, and then is paddled away by Lundqvist.
A couple of good back checks in this period, one by Hagelin a little bit earlier, and the one you just pointed out by Zuccarello, Doc.
Here's Pouliot trying to work his way around. Tucked a little pass that's off the net. Both teams get a man back, and it's Eller bringing it back up. Shoved off by McDonough, followed up by Eller. Eller trying to go around behind and then turns away and drops it on now for Markov. Dead one on and crossed up. The shot blocked by Lundqvist. Backhanded to the corner by Girardi. And then he recovers to float on as far as McDonough.
This chance there for Crust. Cannot miss those chances.
Pouliot jostles there with Markov, thrown by Eller, ricocheted back down off Crust, chases it down with Zuccarello, and they collide. Stepan trying to pick it away, and Crust working it along with his skates. Five left on the penalty to Subban, a single Rangers shot on the power play. Pacioretty guided it back along, pressed from the box of Subban, it's brought on by Pacioretty. Laid it to the back. Weaver's shot, and that one clapped wide. Now it's Georges. Rolled back on off the glass by Strowman. Hustling backboard is Kreider. Crunches into Georges. Follow-up to Kreider. Looks over the options. Jostled a bit by Weaver. Dropped on behind by Stepan. Defended by Georges and reaching in Gallagher off the back of the cage. Battled for by Dorsett. And then it's knifed back up the boards for a little flick by Kreider that's blocked by the Canadians and carried back up by Gallagher. Gallagher fed one that went behind Desharnais, and it's hooked along by Lundqvist. Stahl reversed it, but into traffic, though it careened, fortunately for the Rangers, to Kreider, and then Boyle, and then back in again. 5.5 played second period, game 2, best of 7. Eastern Conference Final, Rangers won the first 7-2, leading in this one 2-1. Off of Briere, and it is Stahl. Run into by Briere, who came up with it, but just that quickly, Klein was there. Briere continuing to work. Not a large guy, but a tenacious one, and then Prust, the large guy, goes behind. Prust laid it to the back. Beaulieu, a shot. Oh, I don't know how Lundqvist could have seen anything coming to him. It did not get all the way there as Boyle led it across. Dorsett, nice toe drag. Moving to the front, the backhander has turned aside.
Oh, what patience by Dorsett there. Great rush by Boyle, who blocked the shot initially to create that chance.
This is John Moore. Winnetka, Illinois product, plays it across, and it's carried back in by Carcillo. Carcillo, a shot that's directed wide by Yemelin. Poked around behind, Beaulieu up the boards. Moore, a shot blocked down by Briere and thrown off the glove. Carried on by Thomas Vanek, who's in. Backhand to the pass and thrown over skated. Entangled by a couple. Vanek slipped it across. Walked in by Plekanec and a drive, and that blocked away. Plekanec again around behind. Trying to play as Galchenyuk, no luck. John Moore fed it ahead. And the booing from the Canadiens fans. It is Hagelin with it. Throws one that's blocked aside by Tokarski. And it's Hagelin again. Reverses for San Luis, but it trickled high. Pumped back up the boards, and Vanek popped it ahead. Hagelin holds, then connects over to McDonough. His shot ricocheted off Tokarski and then came back. Strawman dropped it back along. Markov to take it there. Heads up, tried to fly one ahead that came on to Plekanec anyway. Near the end of his shift, trying to work it further, cannot. Hagelin tripped up. It's taken on by Vanek, but we're going to get the penalty call on a trip. They were cheerful before the game. The fans are plenty ticked off right now. 2-1 Rangers in the set.
Well, the crowd here in Montreal still booing the tripping call to Alex Galchenyuk on Carl Hagelin. Questionable call, to say the least. Power play chance here for the Rangers.
It is McDonough. San Luis. Kreider, and back in deep. Tipped along behind by Stepan and played on by San Luis. Held by Richards. Stoked on back to McDonough. Handed across to Stepan. No one near the front until just now. It is Kreider. Handed on to McDonough. Then across to Stepan. Drive, score! San Luis! A power play goal. Three straight goals in the game by the Rangers.
Doc, this is tic-tac goal. It's about access to the zone. The Rangers do a good job gaining the zone. They set it up, and then they go to work. And the man you want to watch is in the high slot. He's coming in right now, 26 in white. Finds a dead spot in coverage. Watch his body. He goes with the flow of the puck, presents a target. He just blows out through the screen of Chris Kreider and by Dustin Tokarski.
Boy, you talk about moving the puck. You move it, and then you get it into the middle of the ice. And Pierre's point, Marty St. Louis finds a soft point in coverage. Signs it right in that high slot. No chance with Tokarski going down. What a perfect shot there from Marty St. Louis. And a power play, which was much maligned early in these playoffs, has caught fire here as of late. You're going to go through streaks, and no worse time than to go through a tough time when you go 0 for 33, 0 for 34 like the Rangers did at one point in these playoffs. And now, all of a sudden, it's the power play that we saw for a lot of this season. What great movement and great recognition to find that soft area in the Canadiens penalty killing coverage.
Stepan and McDonough get the assist on the goal by Marty St. Louis. They had 9 empty games at one time in these playoffs without a power play goal. Ahead now comes Pouliot, drops it on to Zuccarello, dips the shoulder and backhanded one that ricochets off the trailing Canadian Desharnais. Tumbling down to the ice is a Canadian. It is Markov, and a penalty will be coming up.
And while Pouliot's going to go,
tripped on P.K. Subban down below the goal line. And for Alain Vigneault, he's not going to like that penalty in the offensive zone.
Go ahead, Eddie. Yeah, well, watch Subban here. He's going to get in behind, and as soon as he feels the stick right there, he'll go down. And as the penalty from Galchenyuk was questionable, that one certainly, but
got to give P.K. Subban credit. They're recognizing that the last call was questionable. Any stick behind, get caught up, go down. Wes McCauley with the call. And a huge opportunity here for the Canadians.
I should have given him the credit. Markov deserves something for something in the game, but he got it there. Stepan and McDonough, the assist on San Luis goal. I don't know if this is a series-turning opportunity for the Canadians here, but it would rally their fans at a time that they've become upset at the officials. It seemed disgruntled with Vanek earlier. Canitz moves in away from Dominic Moore. Back on it is chopped off. It's Subban. Read by Vanek. Vanek turning with it there. Ripped across to Subban by Markov. Tipped away by Dominic Moore to the glass. Jostled was Vanek. Taken along by Galchenyuk. Handed onto the back. And it's over to Subban. Fires! And that one held. And then jabbed loose at the last moment. But we get a whistle in a crowd. The two Canadian defensemen do not pull in to assure that the faceoff will be in their offensive end.
Well, P.K. Subban taking that shot from far out there, and any time, as we saw in the prior series with the Canadians and Bruins, shading away and trying to take away that big shot from P.K. Subban, as Carl Hagelin comes all the way out to try to deny, and Galchenyuk standing in front, but Lund was able to see it all the way.
Yeah, he's got to move and go with the flow of the puck. I agree with you. I mean, that's the one thing with a young player like Galchenyuk, who's better on the outside part of the ice than the inside at this time in his career, just didn't track the flow of the puck very well.
Stepan clears it back down.
I think the easiest thing there to teach young players there is you're not trying to score there. You're trying to impair the vision of the goaltender there. You're going to help your team score if you have the willingness, like Pierre said, to get to the front of the net.
Pacioretty, Desharnais, and back to Markov. Then Subban. Wrists it stiffly off the backhand around the roulette wheel to Desharnais. Wanted to play the point, but in the way was Nash, and it's cleared back down yet again.
Real good play there from Rick Nash.
How about the footwork? That's awesome.
Desharnais marches on. Given up, clear. One shot on goal. Montreal power play. They had none on the prior one. Subban led it ahead. Eller brings it on. Offside is called.
I talk about the play from Rick Nash. A couple things to look at. When the puck is going around the boards, this signals to the penalty killers, you want to pressure. You want to put this guy in a tough spot where he has no play. Pressure point, quick release there. Stahl on one end, Nash on the other, working as a tandem. If one guy's going to pressure, everybody else has got to. And that's just an outstanding play of recognition by Rick Nash and Mark Stahl working together in a shorthanded situation.
Olu waits and then advances it ahead for Yemelin. Pass Girardi to the corner. McDonough off of Bork. Chianta played it back along for Eller. Punched by Girardi. Poked up high. Everyone looking for it. McDonough has it. And now it's Pouliot racing back up with it. In a 3-on-2, hands it up the wing for Dominic Moore. Threw one. It ricocheted off Pouliot. And then thumped to the boards was Pouliot. Carried right back ahead by Chianta up the wing. Chianta delays now. Fed one back. Eller a shot, and that hit someone in front. It was Bork. Came on back now for the play by Georges. Handed across for Beaulieu again. And he's able to foist one that becomes airborne off the high glass. Stepan turns, almost run into by Vanek, but it careens back to center. 8.5 to go, second period. 18 shots to 15, just four this period for the Canadians. And they have the lead in shots in the game. But the big board shows 3 in a row by the Rangers. 3-1. Canned along by John Moore. Galchenyuk played it on. Sealed up was Plekanec. Galchenyuk trying again. Around now to the pinching Weaver. Floated back on, and that one shrugged down and trying to play as Nash. Galchenyuk bashed it ahead, but it is thrown along by Kreider. And then Vanek a shot. That went wide.
What a beautiful play there by Galchenyuk to win that battle to get the puck to the middle of the ice.
That's where he's so effective. Plays like that. His skill kicks in.
Vanek kicks it along. John Moore trying to slow him. And it's squirted on free for Galchenyuk to get back to Subban. Subban floated one on. That's off Stepan, who curls, dumps it off past Kreider and back down. So Markov hands to Subban. His team is down by two goals. Subban away from one. Steps in away from a second and is able to get loose with it. Backhanded one pass. Gallagher through the crease wide. Pacioretty is up. Deflected toward the goal. Pressed right back on again. Hagelin able to bump it back to center. Down goes San Luis. But along with it now comes Hagelin. Gibson over to Richards. Across now for control around behind the net. Swirling out is Klein. And that one blocked and then hoisted on the backhand back down by Gallagher. So under 7 minutes to go in the second. Taking a look is Stahl. Just to check the clock. Meanwhile, more changes can be made in the period of the long change. Stahl banked it off of Richards and on goal. Tokarski covers. 6:43 to go. Second period of play. 3-1 Rangers. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico on NBCSN. Edward Jones FaceTime. Pierre's with Rangers head coach Alain Vigneault.
A little bit of a slow start, but you reeled it back in. How'd you turn it around?
Well, they had a real strong push. They came at us real hard. It was tough for us to move the puck. I thought after we scored that goal, right after they scored, we started to play a little bit better. We got to keep getting better.
Can you explain Chris Kreider and Rick Nash and how they helped Eric Stepan?
Sorry, Pierre, couldn't hear
you. Can you talk about Chris Kreider and Rick Nash and how it's affected the line with Stepan?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, Kreider's got a lot of speed and Nasher's got a lot of skill with size. So it's a good duo. You combine that with Step, it makes for a good line.
Thanks very much, Alain.
Thanks, Pierre.
Stahl with a shot that was blocked by Tokarski, and it's not a play that Dorsett could come up with. Meanwhile, it's followed up and played in by Brian Boyle, gathered in by Beaulieu, and scaled on past Weiss and back down, and Stahl after this. Shoved off by Weiss, kicked it along anyway. John Moore saw it go on to Prust, and Prust angled it back. Beaulieu gave it up, carried back up by Carcillo. Crisscrosses there with Dorsett and moves in. Carcillo turning, backhander turned aside by Tokarski. Gathered in there and trying to muscle it in is Boyle. Shut aside and it's Klein. Here's Klein with a drive and that one blocked. Followed through, Dorsett put it off the outside of the net near the post. And then it's jammed right through the goal crease wide by Dorsett. Wow. Two aside, continue the battle. Dorsett tried to muscle it along for Pouliot, who got there. There are loose sticks all over the ice on this play. Just adds to the chaos, and this one scaled back down. And it will go for an icing.
Well, there's PK Subban, and a little bit earlier, trying to be a difference maker. Get this puck in behind Kevin Klein, create an offensive chance for the Canadians with Brendan Gallagher going hard to the net. This last push by the Rangers all started because of the simple play there from Danny Carcillo. Just shovel the puck towards the net. Not trying to make a fancy play, not trying to make a highlight reel. Just get it to the net. And Carcillo did that, and a real positive shift for their Carcillo line with Boyle and Dorsett.
There's no panic on the Ranger bench, but for the first time in a long time, I can tell you, there's a little bit more adversity for the Canadians, and you can hear it down on their bench.
Is it by silence or by a lot of talk?
Of talk, and they're trying to get the referees to fly in and take a penalty or call a penalty against the Rangers.
That one scaled out of play. There'll be no penalty. Play stopped with 5.5 to go. Second period of play. Score of the game, the Rangers 3, the Canadians 1. Mr. Harper, the Prime Minister of Canada, in the middle. Chuck Demers. The right of your screen, the coach of the last championship team here in 1993. One championship in the last 21 years, preceded by 15 in 24. McDonough's shot is blocked by Tokarski. And it is Subban ahead. Rene Bork with this one. Back to Subban. Tries to get by and then filters a pass over for Eller. Eller goes further with it, working it along with his skates before Girardi took over. And then in short order, Pouliot to Girardi. Run into by Bork again. Good work by Bork. Floated it along, gloved down, and then played by Gianta. Tries to hop by him. Bork was able to glove it and play it with his stick, but it is Girardi banking it back along.
That was a good read there for Girardi to take that puck around the boards.
Here's turning his boot, and he jammed it through the crease wide, and near the lip of the crease was Eller. Forced back in by Zuccarello. 4:3 minutes to go here in period number 2. Pacioretty, the first goal scorer, but 17 seconds later tied by McDonough, both unassisted. Then Nash, late in the first, San Luis on a power play midway in the second. Step-on shot is blocked away by Tokarski. Flexed along by Subban, stepping in as Prust came back to Stepan, floated in front off the stick of Tokarski, and then played by Eller and forced ahead. Strawman charges after this, Pacioretty on him, punched along, and Stahl gets it. Anyone who falls now draws the attention of the fans. Up the wing, Gallagher dropped it off Pacioretty. Pacioretty floated, chopped along now, and San Luis can take over. San Luis flipped one ahead that Haglund's able to settle down and gain the zone. Haglund threw it wide, bounced over to Stepan, around behind for Haglund yet again. But it is Markov. Markov with a long toss that's directed back down, and Lundqvist able to stop it behind. Hoisted it off the glass near Haglund, but punched along now for the take and the throw back ahead to San Luis. And then Richards, and then back in.
Rangers playing real smart hockey here. No hold plays, blind passages, keep the puck moving ahead.
That's the attitude on their bench too, Eddie. Really, there's a quiet confidence and a lot of communication.
Yeah, you'd hope so. 3-1 lead on the road. Game two of the conference finals. Be no panic in their game.
Tell you what, you didn't sense this when they were playing Philadelphia, and there are portions of the Pittsburgh series where you never sensed it either. It's amazing how this team has flipped the switch.
Tokarski, a second try here.
I'm going to interviewed Elaine Vigneault here a couple of minutes ago. You're talking about how did his team reel it in? You don't mind, I'm going to answer for the coach part of it. The goaltender, Lundqvist, helped them stabilize their game.
You mentioned booing earlier. One of the loudest boos that I can recall collectively was at Madison Square Garden after game four against Pittsburgh.
Agreed.
Panic shoved that one ahead.
They were just out of gas. I mean, they were just absolutely physically drained with the schedule. They're down 3-1, but they rallied the troops. They found a way to be in the conference finals.
Trying for their fifth consecutive win. As this is thrown in by Galchenyuk and stopped by Lundqvist. So then Stahl with a little over 2 minutes to go, second period. Rust wants to smoke him out. Stahl brings it ahead, jammed on now for Zuccarello. The safe play that Eddie was talking about, just move it on. Comes on back to Strawman, plays it ahead and back in, and a good thump on him. Came from Dale Weiss. Connected on for Weiss, stymied by Strawman, and offside is called, and they are signaling all the way back down for the faceoff.
Well, the matchup that we talked about, the adjustment from game one to two, get P.K. Subban against Chris Kreider. There, takes away his space. This time, takes away his space again. Good. This time, not so much. Backs him off. Now, Derek Stepan makes a good play, but you see the separation because of Stepan and then the crossway speed to Rick Dash. So it's worked for good portions of the night, but when they needed it the most, it didn't because of a smart play by Derek Stepan and the respect for Chris Kreider's speed.
Yeah, on that play there, Subban can't step up on Chris Kreider because he had no support. So I think Subban actually played it the right way. I don't think Josh Georges did a good job there on that particular read, but the speed factor huge for Kreider and the Rangers.
Girardi plays it back out to Subban, who nearly generated something there on a deflection. Around now for Girardi. That one kicked on back for Gianta. Spiked on, and Bork could not come up with it. Shoved off, but returning is McDonough. Moving back in for this is Markov, and Nash on him. Ran right into him. Markov shrugged that off and played it behind for Bork. Girardi defending. Help came from Stepan. Closed off by Eller. And then sailed back out to center. Subban hawked there by Kreider. Able to pivot away. That will be a very popular call here for a couple of reasons. Delayed call is on, and it's Eller floating it off. Markov carries further and shoots. Bad stuff. Rebound overskated by Gianta. Played on the delayed call by Eller. Eller had it taken away by McDonough, and now the penalty call.
Well, as Pierre mentioned, Chris Kreider on P.K. Subban.
Rangers number 20.
reaching around. Right call made. And an opportunity here for the Canadians very, very late in the second.
That's just a young player being over exuberant in that situation for Kreider. He thought he could track Subban down and force a turnover, but you're right. The absolute right call made by the official.
Those are the type that I'm sure Lane Vigneault, Scotty Arneal, Ulf Samuelsson, Danny Lacroix, the coaching staff of the Rangers will show Chris Kreider. Know the situation, know the score. Your stick on the ice, you can't take a penalty there.
Here's Markov firing, and that one ricocheted wide, played by Gallagher. Third power play of the night, only a single shot on goal in the prior two from Montreal. Markov back to Subban, fires, and that one comes right back. Subban again, oh, and that one was blocked in front by Lundqvist.
Boyle's hobbled from that shot block from Subban.
Right around in front, ricocheted almost in. And cleared back down, 7 seconds to go. One last try is wide off the glass, and the siren goes.
Wow, what a couple of chances for the Canadians on this power play late in the second period. Subban with a couple of looks. Pacioretty, support. David Desharnais will throw this puck to the front of the net, trying to get it back door, and it goes off of Carl Hagelund. And off the pad of Henrik Lundqvist, and Pierre made mention of the hobbling of big Brian Boyle. Great shot block there off the stick of PK Subban.
Seems to be shrugging it off, doesn't it? Coming up on the Discover Card intermission report, we're talking about Chris Kreider a lot tonight. Keith will have much to say about him, and the guys will talk about Montreal's fragile psyche. Something that Pierre had alluded to in the latter part of the period. That period is over. It is the second in game two, and the visitors are ahead, 3-1. The Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC are brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. And by Verizon, the official wireless partner of the NHL. It is 3-1 in favor of the Rangers. They'll be shorthanded at the start of the third. Rick Nash with the second goal the Rangers scored. But that's not all he's done.
Well, we got a teaching point here, Doc. I want all you young hockey players out here, watch. Look at the stick of Rick Nash. He's in a perfect position, right? Now watch what ends up happening. He's going to go. Now stop it right here. Watch what he does. He lifts up his stick. Where is the play? It's down here. If you keep your stick on the ice, maybe you prevent Andrei Markov from moving that puck down or keeping it alive. Simple play. But that's one of those that can be preventable and taught when you go to the video. Rick Nash doing a little bit of everything here for the Rangers.
Power play is somewhat abbreviated. Penalty to Kreider for holding 40 seconds from the end of the second. Pacioretty's shot is jabbed away by Lundqvist, bumped in too gently there by Gallagher. Played along by Desharnais. Desharnais fed for Gallagher, short side, a couple of tries. Then he bangs into Lundqvist and play is stopped as Lundqvist kept the puck out.
Couple of times in this game, more than a couple, probably five or six times, the Canadians have generated from below the goal line to the front of the net. There's Gallagher losing an edge. Support down low, playing again below the goal line. Quick little interchange, and he takes the puck right to the net. And a good stop from Lundqvist again.
Important faceoff here for Gallagher and Boyle. False start. The best two faceoff men in game one were Boyle and Plekanec, but they never faced one another in the entire game. That's what's kept their percentages up, but Boyle is just remarkable. He goes to the bench now, and the Canadians had to drop all the way back, and moving this out of Subban, then Pacioretty. Pacioretty delays and walks it in. Dropped it on back. Here's Subban firing! Oh, and a save made by the glove of Lundqvist.
They opened Subban up for the one-timer, and Dominic Moore lost his stick, so he came over to the bench. There weren't enough white sweaters out there, but there was a goalie with a big glove. See Dominic Moore come over to the bench looking for a stick. That opens up PK Subban for the one-timer, no resistance, and
Man, oh man, you talk about athletic and quick, Eddie.
Well, Pierre made the point. There's Dominic Moore coming for the bench. Now it's a 5-on-3. And that's how P.K. Subban gets so wide open. If you're Dominic Moore, you probably want to hang around a little bit longer, even though you don't have a stick in your hand.
He was telling Stephon to go, and then the trainers brought a stick over. That's why there was a little confusion. You should have let Stephon go on the ice.
Boyle could not clear. Markov there, hands it back across. Dealt back along off of Eller, and then jabbed along by Bork. Can be played by Subban, who backhanded it further. Bork chipped it around behind. A diving try by McDonough fails, and it is Markov. Drifting, and they shot one that was blocked by guess who? Ryan Boyle comes to the bench again. Rushing is Subban. Subban steps by and slammed one that ricocheted off Stahl. Stahl delays there, cross-bodied enough by Bork, but it's Nash feeding it across, carried on by Moore. Moore hands back over to Nash. Nash's shot that is covered by Tokarski.
Eddie, I don't think the Rangers knew it was a 4-on-2. Because they just stalled the pace of that attack. It was a clean-cut 4-on-2. Now you see Nash and Dominic Moore talking about it. Quality scoring opportunity blown away by the Rangers just because of a little lack of communication.
And Anton Strom, the defenseman, jumping into the play.
Preoccupied are the Montreal fans enough that they are not booing Kreider now. Here is Lyon throwing one that is poked away from Kreider. And Kreider has it quickly on to Nash. Nash to the back. Shot by John Moore, blocked the side, and it popped up and out of play. Call Star Star NHL to download NHL Game Center and get a free premium upgrade only on Verizon. Enjoy exclusives like free live NBC national games never be without hockey. It was 40 years ago today. Rick McLeish deflected Moose DuPont's shot for the only goal and the first championship in back-to-back years of the Philadelphia Flyers. 40 years ago. 30 years ago, the Edmonton Oilers beat the Islanders in 5, stopping their cup run at 4 in a row.
Do we hear 20? Do we hear 20 years?
I got you.
No.
I got fired 20 years ago.
I was going 20 years ago.
Yeah. Here's Vanek sending one away from Galchenyuk, and why?
Stephon Matteau scored a double overtime winner against the Devils.
There you go.
The conference finals.
That was not the Matteau goal. Nope. That was coming later on. He had two double overtime winners.
Atta boy, Maddie.
Mrkanets fired one along, and it comes all the way back now for Klein. And then floated on back. Yemelin takes over there. Years ago, it was at Madison Square Garden, and it was LaFleur to Savard in OT. That made it 3-1 Montreal. They went on to win 4-1.
Was that JD?
No.
I'm sorry, JD.
Yes. I was just trying to protect you. Across now for Girardi and back in.
Have to ask him about that one down the road here.
Referring to John Davidson, the initials forever, JD. He remembered as the goaltender in 79 and longtime broadcaster, and now with the brain trust of Columbus and having much to do with the resurgence of that franchise. It is Desharnais bringing it on. Knife down by Gallagher. Oh, and a save made by Lundqvist on that. And then another off of Pacioretty.
I'd give Pacioretty a rough ride after he took that second chance opportunity. Well, the story of this game has been Henrik Lundqvist for long stretches. The Canadiens have, especially back in that first period, have had some quality chances, and you see the positioning with Lundqvist able to see that shot, and then good idea from Pacioretty to get that up puck to the net. Boy, Lundqvist has been rock solid. I go back to game one as well. 2-0 game,
period two, the Canadians were coming, had some really good looks. Pacioretty with a great chance. Subban with a great chance. We've seen surges in these playoffs, and when you don't have it, how do you stop it? Well, your goaltender, most importantly. And Lundqvist has done that in period one and back in game one in period two.
Carried ahead by Josh Georgiou. Chopped on a cross, and it came to Prest, who guided it on back. Tipped to nobody in particular, so Briere occupies the space needed.
Seen this belief from the Rangers before. Quick, hard shifts, four-line attack.
Kicked across by John Moore. Run off by Prest, but not until he'd gotten it to center, and here comes Boyle. Boyle drifting with it now. The pass went off of Dorsett. Dorsett swept it on around. Controlled by Carcillo to Dorsett. Tried to turn and take it to the front. No sail. Wrapped one around on the backhand, and that one was wide. And eventually shuttled along by Weiss, but kept by Carcillo. And that one slowed, and it is a restless quiet.
Boy, real good shift there for the fourth line of the Rangers.
You can do that, Eddie, when your legs are fresh. And again, Alain Vigneault has become a much better bench jockey.
You're up by two goals, so a lot easier to go ahead and trust and play those guys in this situation. But remember, they had a couple of real good shifts in that second period as well.
Turn back along again for San Luis. Trying to recover. Backhands it, and a shot by Richards. Skittered off of Bolio, and then off the netminder Tokarski.
Another quick shift. Hagelin changing right now. Richards and San Luis can't be far behind.
Could not feed it through. Every building chant gets shut down by Rangers defensive play. Laid back ahead for the walk back on by Richards. Richards crosses. Slung one on goal that was directed there and then popped one behind Tokarski. That was scooped out. Fans wanted a penalty on Pouliot. Vanek too far for Subban. Long toss ahead, directed back in by Dominic Moore. Tokarski sets it up there for Georges. Turned into some traffic. Kreider there. Then Dominic Moore knifed away for Subban. Taken along by Kreider again. Dropped it back on for the turn by Dominic Moore. To the back it comes to Girardi. Handed across for McDonough. Shot! Oh, and looking behind but having it is Tokarski.
This is surgical by the Rangers right now. Quick card shifts, precise passing. Forecheck pressure, and then pucks on goal. And you look at the Netflix RoboCam, you'll get an idea of what Dustin Tokarski has to look at. Dominic Moore, so far, had a great series. Ryan McDonough walking the line through traffic. Tokarski looks behind, and then for good measure, a little physical play from Dominic Moore.
Yeah, second shift in a row where Dustin Tokarski, not too sure where this puck is, looks over his right shoulder, left shoulder, excuse me, our right. And there you see Benoit Pouliot introducing himself to the young Canadian goaltender.
How about this little change? Marty St. Louis on a line with Stepan and with Nash. No Kreider on the ice. Maybe that penalty?
And St. Louis with a long shift prior to this.
Stepan in with Nash. Tried to work it by and a sprawling play made by Markov. Gallagher rocketed it ahead. Desharnais tried to play it across. Delayed offside is now White. Wallman hoisted one along. It's blocked down by Markov. Markov able to flip one back. Too far for Gallagher. 13:40 to go, third period. Game two. Rangers won the first one 7-2. Ahead in this, 3-1. In 79, the announcers were Danny Gallivan and Jim Gordon of these two teams. Jim Carr would agree the next goal is going to be huge. Thrown by Briere and turned back in to Lundqvist. In all of our handbooks. 3-1, and the way this play has gone, Julio brings it ahead. Throws one that was blocked away by Carcillo. Up for grabs and then knifed by Carcillo away from Briere. Dorsett hustles it on. Subban plays it there.
And they come again. Quick change.
Eller dropped it back in. The frustrating thing for Canadian fans is they can see what the Rangers are doing. They're very well schooled, and they see that it's worked. but still time and still hope, especially if you pay the price of admission here in Montreal.
Double shift for St. Louis, back out there again.
Markov flicked it along behind, hurried along by Georges, help came deep from Plekanec. Galchenyuk rushes ahead. Watching him is McDonough. Galchenyuk dips the shoulder and backhanded one. Shut off by Lundqvist. Grabbed by St. Louis. And St. Louis hoisted back out again. 12 and a quarter to go in the third. The shot's 28-25 in favor of Montreal. That's 6-5 in this period, Canadiens. Plekanec could not grab. Slowed by Dominic Moore, brought back on by Pouliot, connected back up to Zuccarello. Zuccarello drifting to the outside with it now, rifled one across that comes to stall for a drive that's eaten up by Tokarski. 11:50 to go, third period of play. The visitors are still up by two. Here's what's next, presented by CenturyLink. You're on, young man.
For Wednesday night, little bit of a breather. Kings, Blackhawks. And then Thursday night, game three back at MSG. 7 Eastern. Coverage begins with NHL Live. Download the app or watch live online at NBCSports.com/extra.
From the tie-up, it goes to Markov. Nothing early on the Belmont, right?
Oh, no. Still way too much time. Got to worry about the breathe right for California Chrome.
Zuccarello popped one along, but it's carried back up by Desharnais and along to Gallagher. Gallagher toe-dragging a shot was shut wide by Stahl. The scrap behind, Desharnais reaching in, turning it to Strawman, but right there is Pacioretty. Pacioretty rifled it over, Markov, a shot saved. Rebound popped over for Zuccarello.
A good chance there for Markov, good hard wrist shot, but again, nobody standing in front of Henrik Lundqvist. Tough save, but an easy save because he could see it.
No icing on this play. Yemelin touches it along to Markov.
Ryder back on the ice with his line mates.
Blown ahead, but too far for Bork. Icing.
We talk about the chance for Andre Markov, and Henrik Lund was able to see it from our Netflix RoboCam. Right part of your screen. Andre Markov's going to get this puck. Look at in front of the net. There's Henrik Lundqvist. Nobody there. Good job in front of the net there by Benoit Pouliot and Anton Strawman to keep the Canadiens to the outside. Until the Canadiens have the understanding is that the guys without the puck are more important than the guy with it, and Lundqvist is going to see it, they're not going to score.
What a back check by Rick Nash against Lars Eller right there. Wow.
Doing that all playoff long here. And no. Back in that Pittsburgh series, the fans got on him back at MSG in New York. Doing a lot of good things, just wasn't able to put the puck in the back of the net, but that effort's been there all playoff.
Stepan shot is turned aside by Tokarski. Swept along behind Stepan again, tried to center, but Yemelin in the way, and now it's Kevin Klein. Banked one on around and pinching in is John Moore to play it. Drubbed it behind for Stepan. Stepan turned, but right into a traffic. Three Canadians were nearby, and one of them emerges with it, and that's Eller.
There's a good job there from Dorsett on the back check.
Getting a piece of that one was Lundqvist. Now it's Klein ahead, dropping one back in that is wide. Subban to play it there. Marcillo took it away. While falling, got it onto Dorsett. Tried the wraparound, and it was shut off. Nice play by Bork, but it's kept by Dorsett. Oh, and a pad stop made by Tokarski. Another shot rang off the crossbar. 9:48 to go, third period. Double shift, these guys. They look pretty good, don't they? 3-1 Rangers.
It's not always about scoring goals. Watch Rick Nash. He's got two in this series, but he hadn't scored until this series. But he's been doing that all playoff long for the New York Rangers. Penalty killing, back checking, and forcing turnovers.
Well, you love the technique, too. When we showed the play at the top of the third period where the stick was up in the air, that one perfectly done by Rick Nash. Stick on the ice, take away any passing lane.
Off of Haglund. And fed on through for Plekanec.
Nice pass there by Subban.
Lifted along by Richards, ricocheted off a Canadian. That was Georges, punched on now and highlighted by St. Louis.
Greer out here with Plekanec and Galchenyuk.
Trying to get some offense for Michel Therrien and the Canadiens. Again, the guys without the puck are more important right now for the Canadiens to get in front and give Henrik Lundqvist something to think about.
Carried back up ice by Markov, guided across by Desharnais, and it's Gallagher. Gallagher's shot blocked away by Staal. Rangers continue to do a strong job of shot blocking, and if anything gets through to Lundqvist, mostly it's not a problem. Zuccarello able to bring this ahead. Impeded a bit was Pouliot, and that one dropped back in, and after it is Markov. Dominic Moore got there first and kicked it along. Pouliot burrowed into a bit by Pacioretty. Pouliot couldn't settle things down, and so it's carried up by Desharnais. Desharnais to the outside. Puts on the brakes and circles. Got it on back. Hurried shot by Pouliou. Topped on to Pacioretty. Then onto the back for Weaver to give over to Pouliou. Threw it around there, trying for that same play for Pacioretty. Pacioretty able to angle it back. Weaver has shot! And that one went wide. Played along. Oh, and another try by Pouliou. Would not go. Zuccarello jostled a bit by Desharnais, rattled it on around, and the Canadians in the midst of a change. Weaver did not hold it in. Delayed offside is on now. The Canadians peel out, and the Rangers control the puck.
Boy, that shot from Weaver. Good job there from Gallagher, standing right in front of the net. I think it went off his skate, just went past the far post behind Lundqvist.
Deonta shunted it ahead. Rushing on is Eller with it now. Couple of moves, Eller drifts and then dropped it on along, but John Moore got there. He bangs along with Gianta, who steps free. Gianta trickled it behind, hoping for Bork. He cross-bodied a man, and so it's angled on back now for Georges, given across to Subban, trying to shake away from Kreider. Subban watched every inch of the way by Kreider.
Nice job,
still
by
turning,
Kreider.
And they gave it up. Blasted right back in again by Georges. He will head across to the bench in a change as Haglund plays it right back.
Not easy to stay with BK Subban like that, but Kreider's good foot speeds denied him any opportunity to get the puck to the net.
It is Bork, then Plekanec gaining the zone. Surrounded by Rangers. Drifts free and stoked one in front that had to be blocked by Lundqvist. Taken to the outside now by Bork. Given onto the back to Markov. Shoves one deflected by Vanek wide. Haglund trying to turn there. Vanek able to get it again. Thomas Vanek behind, roughed up a bit by McDonough. It's Girardi shoved there by Plekanec. Moore working of the puck along the boards, and it popped onto McDonough, and he's able to step free with it. McDonough able to persist away from the reach of Vanek, gain the zone and trickle it back in. San Luis back with Yemelin, and he takes it. More time goes off the clock. 6 1/4 to go here in the third. San Luis hooked one around in front that's jabbed away by Plekanec and then left for the moment. Pouliot tried for Dominic Moore. It was behind him. Galchenyuk feeds it ahead. Reese can't come up with that one. Settled down by Dominic Moore and handed back for Pouliot and then back in. Under 6 minutes to go. Beaulieu played it back onto Weiss and off Beaulieu to the corner. Galchenyuk to play it there. Has had a good returning game. It's a 3-on-1. Bringing it in is Pouliot with San Luis and Stepan. And the save made. Tokarski holds on to this one in a 3-1 score that his team is trailing.
Well, after taking the Derby and running away at the Preakness, well, I don't know if he ran away from the Preakness. He had to work really hard. On June 7th, will California Crawl make history and win the first Triple Crown in 36 years? The Belmont Stakes, part of the NBC Sports Championship season. Coverage begins on June 6th on NBCSN and continues race day on the 7th of June on NBC.
You got the top three finishers in the Preakness, so why the
little,
long face?
Well, most horses do, don't they?
Pacioretty gives it on across Gallagher. Back from Pacioretty trying to get by to Gallagher, chased off by Staal. In a good defensive play, and the kick across from Kreider is brought back up by Nash. Nash with a shot to the high glass and the bounce, and Nash able to come up with it again.
Really good play by Strawman and Staal defensively.
Nash stokes it on. Oh, and what a save by Tokarski on a bang-bang play. Kreider over to Stepan for the shot. So now Subban, he and Markov, Desharnais, Gallagher, Pacioretty. The main gunners for this team, and Subban with an errant pass. pass off a stick. Dorsett tried to force it in front for Marcello, and it's rushed back out by Gallagher up the wing for Desharnais. Got it on for Gallagher, flipped it on across, and Carcillo and Boyle were doing the defensive job on Pacioretty.
I would think now that the Canadians are going to take some chances with defensemen jumping into the play, try to create a 3-on-3 into a 4-on-3 situation. Brian Boyle has had an outstanding game. We showed a couple of shot blocks while his team has been shorthanded, but that's just a great effort to come all the way back, protect the middle of the ice, work yourself out from there, and Brian Boyle has done it all. But it's been the little things that has allowed him to be one of the big contributors here tonight in Game 2 for the Rangers.
Create a role and get the player to accept it. The player's accepted his role, and he accepted it unbelievably well.
Goalie with the shot. Oh, and that deflected off the outside of the cage by Bork. Touchback on for Zuccarello, who brings it back up with Dominic Moore and plays it back in. Tokarski at the trapezoid, twisted it along. It's, oh, my.
Bad hit by Pouliot. Bad hit behind the plate.
That is on Yamelin, and there will be a penalty. The initial signal is a boarding call. Let's see how much.
I don't think Yamelin had ever had a chance to protect himself. And Benoit Pouliot coming in on the forecheck. Tokarski moves this puck to him. There's Pouliot. Yemlin's right there. You just cannot hit that player when he's in that situation. Defensive player, defenseless player, bad penalty by Pouliot. And there you see referee Wes McCauley. Easy call within 10 feet from him.
McCauley was at center ice about to make the announcement, and then he turned and went back to check on this. This could be pretty significant in terms of the amount.
It's like two, Doc. Looks like it's going to be a boarding call.
It is. It's two.
There's no need to make contact there if you're Benoit Pouliot at all. Know the time, know the situation, know the score. There you see Yemelin going into the Canadiens' locker room right in behind their bench. Goaltender out here. 6-4. Wow, a very early pull here from Michel Therrien.
Scoop back down by Stepan will be gathered in by Markov.
Oh, very early. I'm really surprised he's pulled this early.
Markov able to gain the zone, could not step across, and it's poked right back out again.
Makes sense. His team doesn't have much going on here in the third period. They got to do something.
Hustled in by Subban. McDonough saw it tipped onto the back. Subban with it again. Drop back on now for Pacioretty to work in deep, and a little feed for Gallagher. Did not work from Desharnais. Taken along by Rene Bork. Handed on back for Markov. Spun across to Subban. Fires it wide off the back of the cage. McDonough fires it back off of Subban's stick, and it trickles on its end back down and wide. 1:12 to go on the power play. Desharnais weaving his way along, able to pitch it across for Pacioretty. Pacioretty chipped one that's near Lundqvist. Along behind, trying to dig for it and play it along further with Strawman. Kept at the point by Subban, across to Markov. Markov walking on with it now, dropped it back over to Pacioretty. Subban a drive, Pat stopped, rebound side of the net. Another play is blocked down in front. And a good play made there for the Rangers by Dominic Moore. Moore trying to play it away from Desharnais, no luck. Pumped along by Bork, lifted along by Gallagher, settled down by Pacioretty. 35 left power play, Subban with it there. Watch by St. Louis, drive by Pacioretty, shank loose in front, chipped off of Lundqvist, taken along behind by Bork. Bork to the back again, Subban fires, and it is stopped by Lundqvist.
That last one was sensational by Henrik Lundqvist. He had three Canadians right in front of him, almost making a perfect triangle. Markov, Desharnais, and Gallagher right in front of Henrik Lundqvist.
See how quick he is? Tracking the puck. Pad there, track it again. Watch his head. He stays with him again. He's got to go side to side there through that maze of players, including Gallagher. And here's the last one. Rene Bork gets it back to the point. And that's what Eddie was talking about, that perfect triangle right in front of Henrik Lundqvist. No rebound.
Three to Subban, protects it pretty well. Marches on and escapes Girardi. Right in front, save, Lundqvist again. They battle for it there. It is poked away to the corner by Boyle. And sent back down the ice by Stepo. No problem here because they are shorthanded for 2-1 and no more seconds. Five shots on that power play for Montreal. Subban trying to drift in, and it's poked to the high glass, and he's there to get it. Centered one that's guided away by Lundqvist and cleared back out again by Stepan with 2:10 to go and the net still empty. Long toss for Briere, cut off by Hagelin, played on by Briere, knifed away from Panic in the reach by Stahl. Cranked hard around by Markov. Comes over near Stahl, slowed it down for Zuccarello, but it's punched back in deep. Stroman there, jostled a bit by Galchenyuk, and the battle on. Galchenyuk fed it back up the half boards, poked along by Georges, slugged along behind by Briere, and up it comes for Markov, twisted it on back, and it handcuffed Bannon.
Good read there by Hagelin.
The speed has been so effective for the Rangers.
Markov again led it back on to Desharnais. Under 90 seconds to go. Pacioretty sent it around and Gallagher has it. He's got Eller around behind. Jostled there by Nash. To the back it comes. Subban a shot. Deflected to the corner. Desharnais takes it there. Got it on back to Markov again. Shot one that is cut off. Thrown back down the ice and wide. This time there will be an icing.
Good look at Henrik Lundqvist, and there's the opportunity for P.K. Subban, who hasn't left the ice here in the last two-plus minutes. Great stick in front there by Dan Girardi to take away that possible second-chance opportunity for Alex Galchenyuk. A very slow, deliberate change for the Canadians. They give the guys on the ice a little bit more of a breather.
Here's Plekanec, the best guy in draws for Montreal in this series so far, trying to win one from Stepan, who is the guy who iced it just a moment ago. From the tangle, anticipating with Zuccarello, and he skyhooks it on back, and the announcement for the last minute. McDonough has some trouble. It's tangled in his skates. Thrown along by Pacioretty. Subban with it there. Got it across to Markov. Shoveled one and it went wide as waving at it was Galchenyuk. To the back it comes off of Subban and back down again.
Good stick there by Rick Nash defensively.
All series long, all playoff long. Stick's been there.
Subban able to shrug that off and step in. Throws it to Lundqvist who bobbled it. And then the puck is left for San Luis. But then Subban threw one in and it's blocked away. Briere around behind and that one knifed further by Girardi. To the outside they go in the last 22. Markov swept it across. Subban a shot and that one blocked away by Boyle. Again. It is Briere leaving it behind. Galchenyuk gets it there and Pacioretty couldn't convert. Played around behind again and Briere. Taken along by Pacioretty with 9 to go. To the back. Subban a shot. Glove save made by Lundqvist.
Boy, what a chance for Max Pacioretty. Strength in numbers, goaltender out. Briere below the goal line. There's Pacioretty, and then the save with the left pad. Lundqvist had no idea where that puck was after it went off his left pad.
Poked along, glove down. And the Rangers have won the first two. The siren goes. The celebratory gathering around Henrik Lundqvist, McDonough, Nash, and St. Louis with the goals. The lone goal was the first one unassisted by Pacioretty for Montreal. And now the Canadians have to win 4 of the next 5. A meaningful silence here. Fans sensing, of course, the math that they might not get back here until fall. That'll be determined in New York. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico on NBCSN. Final score in the game, the Rangers 3, the Canadians 1. The best of 7.
led by the Rangers 2-0. For Pierre Maguire and Eddie Olczyk, Mike Emmerich saying goodnight from Montreal. NHL Overtime presented by Bud Light is right after these words.